Milton home sales decreased by 48% since April 2021 and are down 29% from last month. So where have all the buyers gone? We're going to break down what's been happening in the Milton real estate market for you right now.
Sensationalized headlines lead with the numbers that pack the biggest punch, and that is why the media loves to lead with them. The number of homes sold has decreased by nearly half this April over last, but we are still up in terms of the sales prices by 11%. So for the average home today in the Milton market, you are still worth nearly $120,000 more today than you were a year ago. So the sky certainly isn't falling. Putting this into perspective is exceptionally important. The media can make the numbers say whatever they would like them to, and we are here sharing the real data and breaking them down for you to hopefully shed some light on what's really going on to help you make your decision to buy, sell, or invest in the Halton market a little clearer.
So to answer the question, where have all the buyers gone? Well, many are sitting on the sidelines by the looks of it. We've been indicating a shift in the market since our March update, where we saw the market begin to adjust towards the end of February. Looking back now, we can see the peak of the Milton market was in fact February. What we experienced isn't normal in housing appreciation from 2020 to 2022. Historically in Milton, we are fortunate to experience 5 to 8% appreciation year over year. The first time that we saw double digit price appreciation was the 2016 to 2017 year, and then again 2019 until now. A lot of people talk about timing the market and are taking a wait and see approach. There are always ebbs and flows in the market. We talk a lot about the market shifting, but truly it's always shifting. Will prices continue to decline, or will they level out as many in the industry have indicated? Time will tell. We are in an environment currently with increasing interest rates, a provincial election, and an inflationary environment. We see costs increasing all around us, from gas to groceries. We are, however, still lacking in supply in some segments of the market and are opening our border to more immigration and more people to call Canada home. With rental rates at all-time highs, even at the prices today, you're either choosing to pay your own mortgage or you're simply paying someone else's.
If you are in it for the long run, homes have historically been a phenomenal investment and continue to be. If you are thinking of buying or investing right now, ensure you have been pre-qualified and have a rate locked in. Many do not calculate the costs associated with waiting and comparing the prices to the interest rates. If you wait and the housing prices do go down marginally, but the rates go up, you could just be spending the same, if not more, but this time in interest rates. When searching for homes, there are now some opportunities to have home inspections and financing conditions, and possibly even the opportunity to sleep on it and go back to view a home a second time. It's important to always also have a plan B and perhaps consider selling before you buy, so you know exactly what you will have in your pockets at the end of the day, which hasn't been the case for some time now in the Halton market. If you are thinking of selling right now, it is important to position yourself in today's market and in some cases ahead of the market. You must look your best, have some patience and absolute confidence in who you are choosing to partner with. Properties are still selling, and selling well when executed with a proper plan and marketing.
If you want to talk more about selling your home or finding a property, you can book an appointment with us on the Calendly link below. And be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next week.